Kohlberg has two more stages. They are the post-conventional morality level, but not everyone reaches these stages. These are a minority of adults who reason about morality in this way. For Kohlberg, these stages represent universal kinds of morals, the kinds of morals that would apply to everyone regardless of their culture. He calls it a prior to society perspective. In stage 5 reasoning, Joe has the right to refuse to give up the money because each person as a free individual is entitled to enjoy the use of property as long as it does not infringe upon the rights of others. Here we're talking about what people would argue to be a basic fundamental human right, and that this fundamental right would be true no matter where you go on the planet. Then, stage 6 is the kind of morality that you might associate with Gandhi or the Dalai Lama or Mother Teresa. This would be morality based on your own personal conscience, not your social contract, not societal expectations, but because you think that it's the right thing to do. These stages for Kohlberg are linear. You start in one, and you go through to the others. But just because you've passed out of a stage doesn't mean you no longer have access to that type of reasoning. You can reason about morality using phrases and ideas from multiple stages. When you categorize people into Kohlberg stages, you see changes across ages. In this graph, on the x-axis, we have age ranging from 10 years to 36. On the y-axis, we have the percentage of people falling into each stage of moral reasoning based on the kinds of moral reasoning they gave in response to the dilemmas. And the different colors refer to Kohlberg stages, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. You can see, when people are young, they start out in these blue stages, stage 1 and stage 2. They have egocentric kinds of reasoning about morality. As they enter adolescence, those kinds of rationales start to decrease. Through adolescence, people start to rely more on stage 3 kinds of reasoning, so interpersonal reasoning and what is due to you as a contributor to society. Right around 18 or so is when you start to see this marked increase in stage 4, which is the kind of perspective adults reason from. It involves considering common human rights and understanding your own place in society. Although the stage 3 reasoning continues to be commonly used in adulthood. You can see that the percentage of people categorized into stage 5 does increase a little bit in adulthood, but it's not a huge portion of the population. What we can take away from this graph is that there is a developmental trend in how children and adolescents reason about morality. They start out thinking egocentrically, and as they get older, they start to think about principles and society as a whole.